Nissan brought the affordable electric vehicle to the masses with Leaf in 2011. Its next EV effort, Ariya, arrived over a decade later. Until now, all of them in the US have been front-wheel drive. All-wheel drive versions will be shipping with this moniker, eForce. Either the marketing department can't spell, or Nissan executives have a thing for algebra formulas. The plus sign means a larger battery pack, by the way. I'm attending an event in California's wine country. The Nissan staff on hand say EVs like Ariya are a high priority going forward.
A lot of new models coming to market across the globe, including in the US. So we'll have 55% globally, 27 new electrified products by 2030, and 19 new all-electric vehicles.
Nissan hasn't been able to pump out as many Ariyas as it would like because, you know, the supply chain shortage and all. So if you haven't seen one of these in person, on the outside, it's about the same size as a Rogue. But on the inside, cabin space is more like the larger Murano because, you know, electric vehicles, it's very efficient to package their powertrains. eForce models are dual motor. All but the base Engage model make a combined 389 horsepower and 442 pound-feet of torque. The larger lithium-ion battery delivers 87 kilowatt-hours usable. Unlike Leaf, it's liquid-cooled. And as expected, it's floor-mounted for a low center of gravity. eForce Arias can travel up to 272 miles of EPA-rated range. Time to play frunk or no frunk. Ah, disappointed you can't stash your smelly gym bag in here.
This is a design element that we focused on. We pushed the HVAC up front, so there is no frunk, because as far as the frunk goes, not a lot of uses for it, especially in the everyday drives. So we wanted to prioritize where customers are sitting most of the time when they're in the car for, again, that lounge-like living room experience.
Fire Ariya up, and this is what you get. All eForce Arias get an excellent heads-up display that shows loads of information when driving. This is a single-speed drivetrain. Pull back twice to get into a slightly more aggressive regeneration mode. Another setting, E-Step, offers a higher level of recuperation for one-pedal driving. And to change up dynamics, there are modes to soften or sharpen the throttle response and steering effort. Max charging speed is 130 kilowatts. Ariya is not nearly as fast to juice as Ioniq 5, EV6, or even Volkswagen ID.4. If you travel often, at home, they all take overnight. Great that Nissan is using a CCS charge port, but it would be more convenient on the driver's side. With a destination set in the Navi system, charging stations are mapped out along the way. This is hardly the first EV to get a dual-motor powertrain. eForce has extra skills. Nissan engineers took advantage of the instant reaction times that electric motors have and developed algorithms as unique as the spelling.
As you come into a turn or exit a turn, we're able to brake one side of the vehicle, keep the torque to the other side of the vehicle. This is done because we can calculate very quickly with the electric all-wheel drive system. We wanted to make sure, based on our customer feedback and focus groups, is smoothness was very important to them. So having a smooth acceleration was kind of the takeaway. So with our performance teams, we developed the acceleration that you'll see today, which is very responsive, very exhilarating, but yet still smooth. We can minimize the pitch of the vehicle. This is very unique to Ariya. Typically, in an ICE vehicle or a front-wheel drive vehicle, under braking or deceleration, you get kind of that forward dive. With our dual motor, we're able to pull back a little bit to kind of give it more of a flatter ride as you come down to a stop.
This helps to eliminate movements that cause motion sickness in passengers, and over pavement heaves, it can smooth the ride quality. It's so unobtrusive, most will never know it's working. eForce is a $4,000 upcharge. Pricing begins at $48,500 with the smaller 63 kilowatt hour usable pack that's good for 205 miles of rated range. I'm driving the top trim Platinum Plus. That'll set you back $61,500. That's with delivery. Manufactured in Japan, there are no federal tax incentives. Check with your state. Time for some driving. Better yet, let's get the car to do some of the work. Nissan's new ProPilot Assist 2.0 is standard and exclusive to Platinum models. It's similar to hands-free systems like the excellent GM Super Cruise and Ford Blue Cruise in that it uses HD mapping data on divided highways, over 200,000 miles of it in North America. A camera watches the driver. They must look forward and pay attention. This is iPhone video that I just grabbed. Riding for over 5 miles with no hands on the wheel, everything was very confident, even in moderate curves. It will suggest lane changes when approaching slow-moving vehicles. Now, once you signal, it then wants your hand on the wheel. The car then moves over. It kind of feels like a Ouija board as it's all happening. Once the maneuver is done and the icons turn from green to blue, the car is in hands-free mode again. Nissan says the single-motor Ariya will do the 0 to 60 dash in 7.2 seconds. The dual-motor here, 4.8. So if you want the quick one, you're going to go with this. Nice and brisk. I like that. Now, if you're in sport mode, there's a performance tone. I'm not sure if you can hear this, but here goes. It's kind of cool. eForce can vector power front to rear. It's primarily set up to deliver it evenly. There's no rear drive setting for kicking the tail out. Maybe there's an Ariya Nismo in development. This Platinum model at 5,500 pounds, some 2,500 kilos, is the heaviest Ariya. Tossed hard into tight turns, there's moderate body roll. The ride quality is soothing, but controlled. There is a touch of sport in the driving dynamics, but Ariya is pretty much set up for comfort. This would be a great road tripper if not for the slower charge speed. Now, one thing about the brake pedal, there is a good amount of travel. It is kind of soft. Once you get to the bottom, it is firm, but check that on your test drive. Our first stop is Sonoma Raceway, where there's a short course to show some benefits of eForce.
We're going to roll over to the green cones, go full throttle, all the way down to the blue brake cones.
And slam it on?
Sure.
Even with a comfy suspension.
Keep going, keep going, keep going. Nice. There we go.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Body movements are managed under hard braking using rear motor regeneration. A maneuver that most people wouldn't and shouldn't do.
Full throttle around the wet corner.
Yes.
Okay.
I know. Let's see if it does it.
Traction is excellent. The programming doesn't drain power dramatically midway through the curve.
Really nice control, actually.
It's fantastic control. When I jumped in on setup day Sunday and did that for the first time, wait a minute, it's way better than it used to be.
That's pretty much goof-proof.
It's very goof-proof.
Next, a slalom.
I like to say go full throttle through here. Now, remember, you've got a GoPro hanging off back there, so.
Okay, I'll try to clear the cones with it.
The eForce system uses brake and active torque vectoring. Ariya tracks right where the driver is pointing it.
You can feel it working through there as well.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
I mean, it's fantastic.
Yeah.
Usually you go
nicely controlled.
Usually you go through a slalom that fast, you just start to develop a bunch of understeer.
Yeah, I mean, obviously you can feel the electronics kicking in and saying, no, 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 you need to go that way.
Yeah, but it was helpful. So as you gave it this steering, it helped to get us on that intended path.
Yeah.
Rather than just pull everything back or understeer over a cone.
Yeah.
Which you would have had to buy me a beer, by the way.
Glad I didn't have to pay out. Oh. Adding an extra motor drops the distance Ariya can travel. Front drive models are rated as high as 304 miles. The Platinum Plus eForce model that I'm in is officially rated at 267 miles. Obviously, driving style, topography, and temperature affect efficiency.
On events like this, it's difficult to determine real-world range because we just don't have much time with the vehicles. So as far as I can tell, with mostly highway driving, I'm seeing about 20 miles under the EPA rated range.
Consider that my speed varied from 60 to 80 miles an hour. It was windy. Temperatures were in the high 40s to mid 50s Fahrenheit. So this is a pretty good test. A 225 mile trip should be drama free.
By their very nature, electric vehicles tend to be pretty quiet. The Ariya seems a little bit more hushed than usual. There's acoustic glass, extra insulation in the body panels, and the engineers made sure that there's no chattering coming from the suspension parts. That is noise that is usually masked by an internal combustion engine.
The visual of the cabin keeps the chill vibe going, much nicer than Leaf. Let's start with an evolved model. It's synthetic leather in here. Accents are not silver. The Japanese kumiko pattern that's lighted and scattered throughout the cabin is a theme that's repeated all over the car if you look closely. On startup, these emerge from the broad panel that looks and feels like real bark.
So what you don't see is a lot of buttons. We have a lot of haptic buttons. Light press. If you press too hard, doesn't like that. Be gentle with it. You'll get that haptic feedback right away. You can adjust the temperatures. You also notice there's buttons on the side of the center console. We talked about the leg room. You push that center console back, you can spread your legs out. You've got plenty of living room-like experience, especially when you're using ProPilot Assist 2.0. Other buttons that you don't see. So there's another button on the center dash. It says open, close. This opens a front table, so that'll come out. You can use that to put your coffee when you're waiting to charge, anything like that.
Let's move to the Platinum interior. I gotta believe Austin Butler would be a fan of this trim with its blue suede material and all. To me, Nissan's zero-gravity seats are second only to Volvo in comfort. Ariya Platinum is the only EV in class to get Napa leather. They're vented too. All Ariyas get heated seats and wheel. Between eForce and all of the cameras, this car should stay dent-free longer than most. Platinum also comes with an auto park system that I didn't try out. The big glass roof is standard on Evolve and Platinum. There are two 12.3-inch displays in the single housing. Notice the swerve, or that the gauge cluster screen is concave and the interface side is convex. Oddly, there's very little storage in the big center console, mostly the phone charge pad, but the rest of the interior is fairly standard. Not all niceties are high-tech. I haven't seen this in a car before. Nissan has a natural voice command system that I didn't demo. It also has a new customizable user interface. It's a big step up from what I've experienced at Pathfinder and Altima, but still kind of basic, though Nissan claims it's designed that way to keep a driver focused. Touch response is average, a bit laggy in some cases. Android Auto and Apple CarPlay are wireless. It's upgradable over the air.
Remember, rogue-sized on the outside, Murano-sized on the inside. I am 5'9", and back here, I have that much headroom. Knee and leg room are pretty generous. Foot room, maybe a little tight. Cushions are high enough so that thigh support is pretty good, and door openings are big enough so that car seats go in and out without much trouble. Door pockets, those are a little bit small. At least there's storage on both seat backs. And I do like this texture. It's not just shiny plastic. Sort of looks like fabric. One thing that's nice, heated seats are standard on all Arias. This console moves back and forth, and if it is all the way back, it really impinges on the person sitting in the middle.
Switching to the Evolve model, the floor is perfectly flat, helping with foot room. This space is wide enough for three smaller to normal-sized adults, so this would be a decent vehicle for carpooling or family use.
Ariya's form factor is very much like competitors Tesla Model Y, Mustang Mach-E, Kia EV6, and Ioniq 5. Kind of a hatchback-y SUV crossover type of vehicle. It's practical. It's what people want these days.
Adding the rear motor takes away some underfloor storage, but there's room for the supplied travel charge cord and a repair kit. No spare. Bag hooks and cubbies? Check. A semi-hard cargo cover stows here. Just don't pile heavy things onto it. No remote releases. It is a stretch to get to these. Maybe go to the back doors. No pass-through or 40-20-40 split seats. At least the backs fold flat. This is a good amount of room, 60 cubic feet. All seats filled, it's a respectable 23 cubes, so all passengers can take a carry-on suitcase and small bag along. Let's wrap things up with red light, green light. Green light. The eForce system makes for a powerful, secure, and comfortable driving experience. The cabin, with its comfy seating, is a calm, airy living room that makes good use of space. Ariya seems to hit its rated range in mixed driving conditions. The clean, purposeful design is cohesive inside and out. Yellow lights? The ride quality is serene. Enthusiasts will want more engagement. The haptic controls work well, but the Nissan guy is right, not if they're pushed hard. Check that brake pedal travel on your test drive. Seems overly long to me. Red lights. Travelers might be kept waiting at DC fast charge stations with a max charge speed of only 130 kilowatts. There are lots of standard features, but pricing is hurt by lack of federal incentives. There's little storage in the big center console, and motored all the way back, it cuts into rear passenger space. The production Ariya looks nearly identical to the concept unveiled at the Tokyo Motor Show in 2019. In person, it's attractive, but not nearly as polarizing as Leaf. Chunky and svelte at the same time, the silhouette reminds me most of Volkswagen ID.4 or maybe Volvo C30 Recharge, especially these wheels. And like Lexus, Nissan ditched the rear badge in favor of lettering. Good to see a rear wiper. Too many automakers claim that airflow from the spoiler clears rain of the rear glass. I live in Seattle. It doesn't. Fun fact, even though most automakers market this form factor as an SUV crossover, this is classified by the EPA as a small station wagon. Even with all-wheel drive, Ariya is not meant for aggressive off-road maneuvers. Ground clearance is just 6.7 inches.
I haven't driven the single motor Ariya, but the dual motor version here with eForce is impressive. It's quick, it's comfortable, it's quiet, it handles well. If you're looking for an EV, this should be on your test drive list.
Owners will probably never understand how much the eForce system does to keep things calm and controlled. Nissan claims Ariya production is ramping up, that there'll be more of these on the road soon. They should be popular. Let's just hope the next model doesn't take 10 years to come to market. I attended an event where Nissan did a very thorough demonstration of eForce packaged in a Leaf Mule where the system could be turned on and off for comparison. I'll have a link in the video description. It does a great job of explaining the tech in depth. Special thanks to John Vincent with US News and World Report for taking time to help me with car-to-car footage. I threw some GoPros on the back of his car and we motored around for a while. Keep in mind, because of the wide-angle lens right here, I'm 4 to 5 feet off his bumper, so at 50 miles an hour, he had to trust my driving skills. Running footage is very time consuming. I have very little of that at events, and generally I'm the last person back. That was true this time. And once again, I attended an event to shoot this video. The hotel was nice, the food was great, but really, I'm more about getting you accurate information.
Before I go, a quick story. I've been able to do some really cool things in the automotive world. One of the neatest things was just before COVID hit, I was back in Japan covering the Tokyo Motor Show and then was able to go to the Nissan Design Studios where I was sworn to secrecy and shown just about everything the company was going to be putting out for the next 5 years or so. So I was able to see the new Pathfinder, the Frontier, the new Z car, and then this. So it's really fun to see these cars in the real world now, motoring about. There are a couple more things, but I am sworn to secrecy, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Remember, subscribe to this channel, click notifications, follow me on social media, and if you have a question, leave it in the comments. That's Driven. I'm Tom Volk.